the only way this really happens is to... And we do know about conflict resolution, the only way this really happens.
This is Bruce, your supervisor. Bruce, I'd like you to meet Tim. He'll be starting tomorrow. Introduce him to some of the others. I've got somebody waiting downstairs. I'll be back.
Jen. I'd like you to meet Tim. He'll be working with us.
Hello.
Can I leave it to you to go for the job with him?
Thanks.
Have a seat. Are you from around here?
No, I just moved here.
From where?
Binghamton.
So what did they tell you about the job?
Not much, except for that I'm responsible for filing notices and listings.
Primarily death notices. Any other entry that comes in after hours, like classifieds, you simply direct to the respective departments for the day shift to handle. Obituaries normally come in by 5 o'clock, match up a photo if provided. It's not the sort of information we can afford to make a mistake with, so you have to be very careful about it. After you confirm it with the funeral home, it can go to press. Do you know what your hours are? Sunday through Friday, start at 4, end at 12:30 with a half hour for lunch. If you've done everything before then, you're free to leave early. But remember, it's all on punch clock. When do you start?
Tomorrow.
Obituaries normally come in from the funeral home by fax. Some things do get hand-delivered, and security would bring those up to you after hours. That doesn't happen too often. Come in.
I'm sorry, I didn't realize you had somebody with you.
I didn't forget. I'll come down and see you when I'm done.
Okay.
I've got to go, so let me get you started with poor Mr. Petrovic.
the one we've always been looking for.
Whenever the phone rings in the middle of the night, it either means that somebody's dead or somebody really, really, really wants to come up to see you. Well, the truth is my mother is dying. Besides that, it could only be a wrong number. Hello?
Can I please speak with Tim?
This is Tim.
This is Edna Walker. Sorry to call so late, but I am looking after your mother, and she is not doing well. You should try to come home as quickly as possible.
Okay, I'll do that. Please tell her that I'm coming.
I will.
Good night. Ms. Walker? Hello, Bruce. This is Tim. It's about 5 in the morning and something just came up. I have to go see my mother out of town. It's an emergency and a...
Hold on. You can't come in. What's up?
My mother's sick and I have to go see her. I need to catch the 5:30 bus.
Oh. When do you expect to be back?
I don't know. I just got the call last night. It sounds pretty bad.
Someone to cover for you.
Sorry about this.
Don't worry about it. I mean, people won't stop dying just because you can't come into work. Just let me know when you expect to be back.
I will. I'll call. Thanks.
Day wears on, starting off with more clouds and then into the afternoon.
I need one ticket for the 5:40 bus. I need a ticket for the 5:40 bus. One ticket for the 5:40 bus. How long before we get to Cortland?
Barring some unforeseen road tragedy, we should be there within the hour. Door stop. Hey, buddy. Come on. Let's go. Come on.
don't want it.
I don't need it.
Yes, you must be Tim. Come in.
In touch with your mother's lawyer. Have you spoken with him?
Yes, and I've asked him to settle it as quickly as possible. I don't want to have to deal with any of this anymore.
Okay.
anything else?
No, can we have the bill? Sorry to hear about your mother. You really didn't have to come back to work so soon.
Thanks, but I'm all right.
Was your mother ill? What happened?
Cancer. Are you a cancer?
Don't be such an idiot.
Come on.
I'm just kidding.
Don't worry about it. And no, I'm not. I was born under the sign for those left to wonder why a child of God walks like a shadow to the Shangri-La.
What?
Never mind. I gotta go. I'm calling from the paper to check an obituary.
Your name?
Tim.
Oh, yes. And the name of the deceased, Tim?
Hoffman? Martha Hoffman?
Just a moment. What should I say? tell her we don't have anything here. Oh, I'm afraid we don't have anything here from you to confirm regarding a Hoffman.
Oh, you don't? It's your listing, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
But I'm certain I put it through to you last night.
Last night? Now, that would be rather queer, wouldn't it? Given as she arrived this morning.
This morning?
Yes, this morning. Perhaps you should try sending it again.
I'll do that.
Thank you. Call again.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Excuse me.
But for what?
For granting peace and comfort to the deceased. Have a good night.
I will. Hi. What's your name?
Nada.
Have a seat. You from around here?
No.
Where are you from?
I'm not from around here.
Sorry, I was just asking.
Well, don't. If you want someone to talk to, maybe you should
just... All right. Go then. But if this makes any difference, then stay. But please, no bullshit, because I can go just about anywhere else and find that.
Well, you've come to the right place.
Sit down. Do you know what nada means?
No.
It means hope. But in another language, it also means nothing. So tell me, what would you rather be doing?
That'll be $6.50, honey.
Do you mind?
Go ahead, it's yours.
So then, what would you rather be doing?
What do you mean?
I mean, if you weren't doing this, what would you rather be doing?
I don't know. I couldn't tell you. You ask a lot of questions.
I do. Do you mind?
Normally, I would.
Well, I'd really like to know.
I'm sure you would. But if it wasn't me sitting here, you'd probably just be talking to somebody else.
Probably. But it just so happens that I'm here.
Tim?
Yes?
Have you spoken to Bruce? Have you spoken to Bruce yet today? Can you go see him in the press room? He's working by the sheet fed.
I need you at midnight for at least 2 weeks. I'll explain later. Can you do it? He's Lawyer tomorrow at 10.
Am I in fact alive? Or has the dream been my one brief moment of life, of conquered and experienced reality?
Hi.
What time is it?
It's just after 9. Why? How long have you been here? I start work at 10. I just stopped in for a quick drink. Do you want one?
You know, I couldn't sleep last night thinking about something that you said.
What did I say?
When and where does it end?
What do you mean? It ends when it ends.
Have you got a quarter? When and where does it end?
Hello. Hello.
Yes?
This is Anton. We haven't met yet. I'd like you to come and see me. I've got something for you. I'm down the hall. I've left the light on.
This just came in. Include her with the others.
Surprised we never met before. Are you new here?
No. I've been here a very long time. I normally work down below.
It's a bit late for a notice to come in. But I'll take care of it.
Good idea.
Got a minute?
Hold on. What's up?
Who's Anton?
Anton?
Yeah, that old guy who works the night shift. He came up to see me the other night. It was strange.
In what way?
Who is he?
I don't know. There aren't too many people here after hours. Security, maintenance, yourself, and the people in the press room. Maintenance is more or less short in Italian. Security is contracted, so they change all the time. He's probably from the press room.
And when I finished college, I really wanted to go home and spend time with my parents. But then this job came up and I moved here. I started in September. I'm a marketing assistant. It's really interesting. I really enjoy it.
When did you start?
In September. What about you? How long have you been here?
27 years.
No, I mean in the city.
Oh. Days.
Did you come for the job, or...?
No, not really.
Hi. So,
but
what...
I guess it just worked out that way.
So, what exactly do you do up there?
At work? I file death notices. You know, obituaries?
That's too weird. I couldn't do that.
Someone has to do it. So, what do you like to do with your time? I mean, like, when you're not working?
Oh, God. I don't know where to start. Well, I worked this past summer as a lifeguard, and I just love that job. And if I wasn't working, I was either playing beach volleyball or on a jet ski. That's all I ever did.
Hi. I
I used to see you coming out of... And then I saw you in my dream last night. My name is Maya.
Sorry, my name's
Tim. Do you know
what
Maya means?
No. Oh, at work? I file death notices. You know, obituaries?
That figures, because you've always struck me as rather odd. Don't worry, though, because with me, that's a good thing.
What about you? Tim?
I'll let you go for now. I'm always here. Why don't you stop Tim? By sometime?
This is where I live. Just a minute. I know it's not much. Hello?
Hi, this is Maya.
Yes?
We just met this afternoon and I was hoping that we could... Hello?
What the fuck?
Hello?
Hello? I got your note.
Shh, sit down. I was expecting you. Sit down, have a drink. I'll be back in a second.
Who else is here? I saw you talking to somebody in the kitchen. What's so funny? Where are we? Where have you brought me?
Determinism is a theory that the world is everywhere subject to causal law, meaning that every event that occurs has a cause. If it is true, then every event that actually happens has to happen.
What are you doing?
Since it logically follows that from a description of the conditions of its occurrence, together with the relevant laws of nature, that it has to occur. Likewise, any event that does not happen could not have happened. Now, if human actions are to be included in the deterministic system, it follows that no one could ever have acted otherwise than how they did. And therefore, though Hume and other philosophers have disputed this, that no one is morally responsible for their actions.
Shh, please, not now. Welcome, Tim. I've led you here with good reason. I was certain it was going to be far more difficult for me to do so. Well done, Maya. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, Tim, but your life until now has passed rather inconsequentially, hasn't it? A perpetual non-event. Day to day, week to week, month to month, year to year. Unto death you can rest assured. Rather unspectacular, if I may. Not the stuff of any interest to anybody, let alone yourself. No family, friends, or foreseeable future. nothing now but a leaden present, compounded by a pervading and all-too-real sense of solitude and displacement that has always been and always will be yours. Fictions are contrived to momentarily relieve people like you. Films, novels, television. And now I'd like you to function for me. I'll try to put this as simply as I possibly can. Tim, you've been written into a fantastic scheme. You don't know it, but you've already been scripted as an agent of fate. A critical detail in that seemingly random series of details into which you've been most specifically positioned. For my purposes, you will be instrumental in the turn of events that will lead to a prescribed person's demise. Not an assassin, but the critical detail to bring it about. We will get you into and cleanly out of every scenario we orchestrate. I know it sounds like some absolutely profound nonsense, and that's what it is, if you accept it purely on dry logical terms. But it will require a bit of imagination on your part to play it out effectively. Having said that, I do not want you to think for a moment that I am not absolutely serious about all this. I am only interested in being successful. Carry on as directed, and you finally will have found your place in the scheme of things. There is much at stake in the success of this production. I expect full cooperation. I mean, I'd hate to have to write you out of the script, so to speak.
Walter Sutton? Douglas Sutton Memorial Chapel? Yes, we have spoken a little, but we've never formally met.
Tim, I think that I've explained myself sufficiently. Do you understand what I'm trying to tell you? Take two. I think that I've explained myself sufficiently. Do you understand what I'm trying to tell you?
I don't know what the hell you're talking about.
Tim, I'd like to show you something. Take a look at these. This is what you will wear. As you can see, it fits perfectly. Gloves. Now keep them clean, and remember to wear them at all times when doing your dirty work. And of course, your lines. Tim? No need to try and find us. We'll find you as you are required. And don't mention any of this to anybody. You'd be crazy to. No. It's yours now. Now, is it beginning to make some sense? It will.
At work, I file death notices, you know, obituaries.
up the telephone.
Tim, this is Anton. Meet me in the top tier of the parking structure at 6:30 this morning. Tim?
Yes?
6:30. You'll be there?
I'll be there.
Here, you need it. Take it. It's only black. I haven't even added cream or sugar to it. I want to assure you that everything you thought might have happened last night did actually happen. I mean, the fact that you're confused is understandable, but you really need to have some imagination about all this and go right along with it. Whenever you scan the headlines, have you ever wondered what hand is at play? Well, now, you're privy to understanding the workings and will be able to answer that most elusive question, why? And for maybe the first time in your life, you can feel as if you're in the right place at the right time. You will administer with impunity if you act as directed. You'll be absolutely transparent.
But why me?
Because it's been written that way. If not you, then somebody else. Anyways, it's too late. Don't make it difficult for us. Let me ask you something. Look down there. From where we are, do you feel any pity if that speck down there stopped moving forever? I mean, you can already accept the fact that it will stop moving and disappear one day. Now, if you had to keep your speck moving for every speck down there that had to be stopped, would it be much of an issue to you then? Whether something happens by accident or intent, the effect is still the same. Things happen. One way or another. Observe.
I understand you. I already know you. I've always known you. I will always be next to you. From this moment, you'll never be alone again.
Thank you.
I'm a dead man, lady. But this movie will be over long before they ever catch up with me.
Hi, this is Maya. I think it's about time for us to get together and make things happen. You know where to find me.
Hi.
Can you bring those things upstairs for me?
Sure, I can do that.
Be careful not to drop them. They're heavy.
What is this?
It's a movie.
What?
I said hi.
Hi.
No! Wrong! Cut!
What am I supposed to do?
What?
What am I supposed to do? What are you going to do?
I'm going back upstairs.
No.
Why?
No. Come with me.
Hey! Stop! Please!
Yeah.
Let go! Let go! Go with me!
There's much at stake in the success of this production. I expect full cooperation. I mean, I'd hate to have to write you out of the script, so to speak.
Who is it, honey?
Hey, what? Hey, take a look at that. Get over here, you fool.
Stop! Right there. I'm afraid that this has gone far enough. I'm sorry that we are going to have to end it this way.
Can I help you?
Hello, Tim. This is Anton.
What do you want from me?
You! Lock the door!
Who are you? What do you want? What are you doing here?
I'm a dead man, lady. But this movie will be over long before they ever catch up with me.
Yeah.
Timothy, just as the shepherd brings in his sheep, the fondest hope of the lost child of all of us, that we shall one day return to the flock of our own, the hope of the life eternal. Cares to look down upon the sick, the suffering, the dying, yes, the dying, and to the icy tomb, to the cool repose of the crypt, thou shalt return to the dust from whence thou came, and then only the bones shall be. The worm shall consume thine eyes, thy lips, thy mouth, they shall enter into thy ears.
Now that you've found me, you won't have to search.